our friendly neighborhood VTuber Suvi here again with a new tutorial. So today I'm going to show you guys how you can use a video file as a texture. Now this could be played on a screen behind you, or it could even be played on your clothes or skin texture if you wanted to do it like that. And it could even be used as a texture for a special effect like matte caps or anything else you may have in your shaders. So, for this tutorial, you will need Unity, of course, and then UniVRM and the VCFace SDK. I recommend you use UniVRM 0.66 for this because that is the best version to run at the moment. Anyway, let us get started with the tutorial. Okay, so as always, we start in a situation where we have already imported our model into Unity. And of course, we have the VSF SDK also imported. So what we are going to be doing is we will be creating a simple video player for our avatar. Now you could, of course, just use the video player to animate your clothes or your skin texture. But today we will create a simple quad and then play a video on that. So first of all, let's create the quad. So for this specific case, I'm going to add the quad to our avatar's head. So I have opened all the way until the head and then simply right click, and then we are going to add a 3D object, which is a quad. Now I'm going to rotate this quad around so that it will be facing the camera, and then I will move it to the side. So let's do that first. Okay, now we have our quad in place. The next step we will do is we're gonna remove the mesh collider. We do not need this component this time, so remove that one. And next, we are going to be creating a new component. So click the add component and search for video player. And then let's add the video player component. So we need to do some settings on this one. Now you have multiple ways to use this. The play on awake means that the video will play automatically. Now this is a good setting to have on. So whenever you want to play the movie or animation, you can simply make this video player active and the video will start to play right away. Another thing we could do is make the animation loop. Now this is totally up to you if you want the looping animation or not. For this tutorial, we will set it on. And you can also adjust the playback speed as well as some other settings. But the important thing is the render mode. So we will select render texture. Now what this will do is that it will render this video to a texture file. And then we will be able to use this texture file on basically any material. So this means that we could assign this specific material, for example, to our character skin, but we can also assign it to this video player object here. So how to do this? First, we will need to create a new render texture. So right-click somewhere in your project, then go to Create, and then click the render texture. Now we are going to name this video texture. You can of course name it anything you want. Now for the size, you could set any size here. Just remember it needs to be power of 2. I'm going to keep it at 2, 5, 6, which is gonna be pretty small, so our video will be quite pixelated, but you could set it to 1K or 2K or possibly even up to 8K if you wanted to. The other settings here I think are just fine for now. The next step is to import the actual animation. Now for this case, I have simply downloaded a clip from my Twitch channel, so I will be using that one. So drag that one in to your project. Do remember that the format should be something that is supported by Unity. You can check the supported formats from Unity's homepage, and as you can see, they recommend the H.264 codec as an optimal one. But of course, do check the compatibility to see which one works with your platform. Okay, so we have our video now dragged in here. Now let's select the video. And there are a few things you need to take into account. For example, when you try to click the play, your video may not actually play completely. So how do we fix this? There is the transcode thing. As you can see, it says that not all platforms transcoded. Clip is not guaranteed to be compatible on all platforms without transcoding. So what we should do is we should transcode this clip. So click on the transcode here. For the codec, I recommend you select the H.264, which was suggested by Unity as well. So select that one. And then simply click apply. This will take a while. After Unity has processed the file, you can try clicking the play again and your clip should work. And as you can see, it is working. So the next step is to put this all together. So to do that, let's select our quad again where we had the video player component. And now what we are going to do is we will drag this video texture to the target texture slot. And then we will drag the video file to the video clip. Now do notice that in theory you could also play from an URL. But I have not tested this. It might be possible, you can give it a try, but you may run into some codec issues if you do that. Now, if your file has audio, you can set which channels to use here. So I'm personally just going to keep this audio track on. You can do whatever you want with your video. And the next step is to create the material. Because right now you see that our quad is still using the default material. So we're going to create a new material. So right click, create and material. And let's call it video material. Also do notice that you could simply just use this texture on your character's texture instead. We can also test that one out. So for now, let's drag in this video texture to our new material's albedo value. It will show us black here, don't worry about that. And now we will drag this video material to the quad, like so. Before we export this, let's also try applying the same video texture to our avatar. So let's select our avatar and let's replace our clothes texture with this one. So the top. So drag the video material to the tops, like so. Of course, when you do this, you have to take into account that the UV map will not be correct. So this will look pretty bad this way. But if your video is using the same correct UV coordinates, then you could animate clothes really nicely. Or depending on what shader you use, you could animate some special effect texture as well. Anyway, now the next thing for us is to export our model. So again, select your model, go to VSF SDK and export avatar bundle. And let us find out how it works out in VCFace. And now if everything worked correctly, you should see the video playback on both the quad as well as the clothes. Now you will see that the texture looks kinda white-ish or gray right now. That is because of the material properties. So you will be able to adjust the material properties in Unity to make it more clear. We can actually do that as well. So let's return back to Unity and then select the video material. As you can see, we are using the default standard shader. We could just set the smoothness and the metallic values to 0 and maybe darken the color, turn off the reflections and specular highlights. And if you give this a try now, it might work better. And as you can see, now the colors look correct. I hope you like the content. And remember that you can use this technique to do so, so many different things. Only your imagination is gonna be the limit. So make sure to show me if you come up with something fun. I would love to see those as well. Anyway, guys, if you like the content, consider subscribing down below as well as smashing the bell button down there. I also have other social medias if you would like to follow those. And I do stream on Mondays, Thursdays and Saturdays on Twitch if you would like to ask any questions live. That is totally fine. I do also have a Discord server, so if you run into any questions, make sure to join that one and ask your questions there. Anyway, guys, see you next time. Bye-bye!